Good morning. So my name is Ruby from FNR Transport, and this morning we are trying to find my spouse a load from San Diego going anywhere for the 27th of May. I am currently on my truck stop online load board, and so I'm just kind of browsing the load board to see what's within his range. He can haul up to 17,000 pounds because he is a CDL driver and 40 foot of for the trailer. Okay, so we're gonna call on one. Looks like it's picking up in, let's see, Corona going to Fort Worth. It doesn't have weight or length on it, so we're just gonna give him a call and see what it is. So let's see, it's 1369 miles plus my 96 of deadhead. Let's figure that out. 1369 plus 96 of deadhead equals 1465. I'm gonna times that by two. Should be 29. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and give them a call and see what they say as far as the weight and length. But I already have my numbers figured out, and so then I'm just gonna go from there determining how much the load weighs. Because for both loaded miles and deadhead, it's...
Good afternoon, Hedrick Logistics.
Hi, good afternoon. I'm calling about a load that you guys have from Corona, California, going to Fort Worth, Texas.
Roofing tile. You're going to need B-boards. The B-boards need to be at least 3 feet or longer. 4 foot drop tarp, 48,000 pounds, pace 31.
Oh, yeah, that's too heavy for my hot shot. Sounds good. Thank you for your time. Ah! He literally hung up when I said my hot shot. Then put it in there. See, you know what I'm saying? They don't put in the weight, they don't put in the length, but then they get all these calls. But it's just like, then put in the detailed information so you don't get these calls, these, you know, callers calling you for a load that's not even applicable to them. So that is okay, Hendrick Logistics, you douchebags. So we're going to remove them from my list. And I should call him back like, excuse me, you disconnected and I wasn't done saying have a great day. God, people. And that's the thing. That's what like irks me is that, you know, they post loads and they don't have the description fully there in the load board. They don't have the length. They don't have the weight. You know, most of the times they don't even have the rate that they're wanting to ask, you know, for that load. So you have to figure out your, you know, you have to calculate your deadhead plus your loaded miles. And we're going off of $2 a mile for everything. And so far we have gotten more than $2 per mile on all of our loads so far. And we've just only been in the business for 2 weeks, going on 3 weeks next week. So we've been getting pretty good rates, but because I've been having to negotiate some of those rates, this is the first time I had somebody hung up on me, but I'm not going to really let that affect me in calling and making calls, because not all the brokers are like that. Some of them are really pleasant to work with, and some do pay you good rates, and some will negotiate and give you that extra $100 and $200. So do not call the brokers and not negotiate those rates. Have your rate already set up to what you want to get paid. So when you're calling to negotiate, you know what you're needing for that load. Okay, so excuse the noise, my boys. So I finally booked him a load. We didn't settle at all today. And so it literally took me all day to find him something good. I did present him, my driver, which is my spouse, with a few loads. And he had declined quite a few. And then we had some that were really good loads, but then they canceled on me because the shippers wanted to wait till after the Memorial Day weekend, which is understandable because then that means, you know, we would have to hold the load till the first. And on one of them, we were going to hold it till the first because it was well paid. But since we're going to a graduation in California, I need to keep my husband within that area so I could easily bring him home for the graduation ceremony. But long story short, I did not give in. We did not settle for anything less than $2. We did finally, at the end of the day, book a load from California. within California. It's about 380 miles. That load was paying $4.21. It was $1,600. We did have about 112 deadhead miles to get to the location to pick up the load. So that brought us down to like 320 because of the deadhead miles, which is still not bad because they paid $1,600. It's only like 6-7 hours of a drive. And we were way, well, we would have been way over $4, but our deadhead. So we always have to count our deadhead miles. But at the end of the day, we got something really good. We didn't settle for anything, you know, those cheap loads. It's like, you know, this is our livelihood. This is the way we pay our bills. This is the way my kids eat. And we're able to do all our, you know, stuff and maintain our business. So I think we started off on a great foot. The first 2 weeks we earned, first 10 days, we actually earned $12,000. Our goal is to hit 20,000 by the end of the month, which is the 31st. So I had another load from California, which is Oakland to Salt Lake City, Utah. And that one was going for 1,800, and that one was paying like almost over 350, almost $4 the mile, which would have been ideal for us to have taken it. But I couldn't have signed that one until I signed the Raycom from the one from California within California. But I told my husband what I should have done is I should have called that broker, the one from California to Salt Lake City, Utah, and had them, you know, start negotiating rates and whatnot. That one I wouldn't have negotiated on because honestly, they're paying almost $4 a mile from California to Salt Lake City, Utah. I would not have negotiated because then I would have been a little too greedy. So what I should have done, I told my husband, was called ahead, you know, got my details and told him I was interested in the load. Had them send me over the carrier packet so I can start doing the paperwork, because I know I was not enrolled with that company, while I wait for that Raycom to come in from the one from California to California. I should have worked in advance, but I didn't, because I was like, I don't want to start this one until I have my Raycom signed from the one from California to California. And by the time I signed my Raycom from the one from California to California, I called the one from California to Salt Lake City, Utah, and it was gone. I was like, no, it was gone. That would have been ideal. It would have been ideal. That would have been like 3,400 in 2 days. And I know now for the next time I'll do that. As I'm waiting for the Raycom, if I see another load, instead of waiting to sign that Raycom, I'll just start my paperwork for the carrier packet for that other company. And it don't hurt none for me to start that carrier packet, whether the one that I was waiting for fell through or not. I would have just, you know, I would have just signed up with that company. So there's things that I'm learning as I'm going. This is still my second week going into my third week. I'm not in my third week yet. So we're just closing off our second week, and me and my husband made pretty good money. Bless his heart. He's out there driving. He's tired. He's eating late. And you know, I told him, I'm not going to keep you out for too long because it's not going to be fair that you're just out there busting your hump. Yes, I'm home. I'm doing all the paperwork. I'm making the phone calls. But I need you to come home at least once a month to spend time with your family and your kids as well. This is a huge sacrifice for us. It really is. It was really hard for me to separate from my husband as much as it is for my kids to separate from my husband. That first week I broke down crying because I'm like, this is too hard. This is how it's going to be. And then I had to regroup. I had to, you know, get myself back on track on my thoughts because I knew this is going to be for a better outcome for our family. And so I'm really putting in all the efforts that I can. I'm studying as much as I can, how to negotiate. I still need to learn. I really need to learn how to do partials. We haven't done any partials. But I know there's going to come a time that I'm going to have to depend on doing partials to be able to get our money that we're looking for on a daily basis. And so far we have gotten all of our loads over $2, and we've been primarily in the Arizona to California for these last few days. Arizona has a lot of loads for Hotshot, and so I told my husband, I'm just going to kind of learn the market in certain states before I just kind of expand to every state. I'm going to try to stay local for a few months so we can be very familiar with the rates, with the way the market is, what, you know, what the prices for Hotshot are really actually going for. Because if you don't know, these brokers are just going to walk all over you. And, you know, I'm sure on some of these loads they have, but on these loads that I'm getting paid over $2, I highly doubt that they are. So, but we did did seal a good deal this evening. Tomorrow will be another day. I'm confident that we'll find something really good tomorrow. And hopefully I can get on some more phone calls and show you guys how I negotiate. The one from this morning that I called the broker that just literally hung up on me, that was not the first one today. I actually had another one. I was just like, oh, you know, it's too bad. You know, I have a hot shot click. I was just like, okay, that's okay. Like, you know, I don't take any offense to that. You know, that's just, is that your work ethic? That's on you. That's a reflection on you. You know, you've probably been in this business. You're probably worn out and burned out from this business. Maybe you should reconsider something else, you know? But overall, the brokers have been very pleasant and very good to work with. So I'm going to go ahead and keep my chin up and keep supporting my husband in this journey with him. And be sure to look at his videos that he's uploading, you know, go give him, you know, a heart and like and share. And don't forget to follow us here on YouTube. More hotshot videos to come. Thanks for watching, you guys. If you guys have any questions, please let me know in the comments below and I'll be happy to help you guys out. Take care. See you guys on the next one.